Today, I will like to share with you the beauty of pure heart. Innocent and pure hearts, they attract grace very naturally. It simply flows without any resistance. And when there is purity in the heart, there are no games, no politics, no corruption. There will always be truth prevailing. Such a heart cannot lie. And as a result of this prevailing of truth, automatically your heart will remain contented. It will develop a lot of satisfaction, santosham, as we say. And because of all this, I think wherever there is satyam, wherever there is santosham, and wherever these two settles in the heart, automatically the beauty will emanate from within. See? The beauty of Babuji Maharaj, I mean, you just keep on looking at him for hours together without speaking a word. That is because of his not just ordinarily pure heart, but divine and pure loving heart. See? And that's what he is trying to inject in us through transmission, that we become more and more loving, and as a result, developing that purity and becoming like him, divine purushas, you see, divine men and women walking on this planet. That is the dream, see. When we meditate day in and day out, doing our cleaning, taking sittings, with a lot of love, we experience various conditions. The number one condition I just shared with you is that of santosham, and also sage Astavakra. He gives so much of emphasis on santosham. The very first requirement, he tells Raja Janaka, if you want to achieve liberation, if you want Brahma Vidya, and if you want to remain detached, develop this quality first, santosham. In Sahaj Marg, with our practice, the santosham develops naturally without me worrying about it, because our desires slowly and slowly subsides, and we come to a level where Babuji, quoting him again, I would say he talks about more and more of less and less. And what is this more and more of less and less? He says more and more of less and less desires. And when our desires become zero, then there is so much of joy in life. There is contentment, santosham. As this santosham really develops in our heart in a very natural way, we'll have param shanti. That is the quality of our second chakra or the atma chakra. So in English, it's very easy to remember these five C's. C stands for contentment, which belongs to, rather, it's a quality of the first chakra. Calmness, shanti, is that of the Atma chakra. And when we move to the third chakra, it is all about love and affection. What do you call love in Telugu? Prema, right? It also can be called as sneha. Or it can also be called samvedana, right? Samvedana. And the quality of the fourth, in English we call it courage, sahasam in Telugu perhaps. And the fifth chakra is all about bringing the clarity, where there is no illusion left. You're so clear, spashta. So in English we say, but it is these qualities of five chakras are represented by five C's. Number one C is contentment. Number two is calmness. Number three is compassion, love. Number four, courage. And number five is clarity. Likewise, in Telugu, we can also have, instead of five C's, in Telugu you can have five letter S, starting with santosham, shanti. Then here will be sneha or samvedana. And here, the fourth will be all about courage, that means sahasam, again, letter S, and the clarity in spashtata. So I think it is coming up so well, these qualities, just as we have tried to simplify, you know, those five A, E, I, O, U, and when we master this A, E, I, O, U, I hope you know what I'm talking about, right? This will end up developing these five C's or five S that you now have come to know.